Do you want to help me start the video?
Hey there guys, welcome back to Calico Cow Acres. Taylor is going to be filming a video for you today. We are finally getting to... We're finally getting to working on the watering system post getting the IBC tote set up. We've got, I don't know if you can see it back there, but we've got probably, it's almost halfway full. I kind of expected it to be more full than that by now with how much rain we've been getting.
It's almost at the 125 gallon mark, so we have gotten quite a bit of water off it. A lot of the rains we've been getting, I feel like, have been like heavy but kind of short storms. But I mean, still, that's more water than the chickens will probably use in 6 months.
Yeah.
So
it is also the time of year where the garden centers and the local nurseries and stuff are having like half off sales because they're closing for the season and they're just trying to get rid of their stock. So we went to a local nursery this morning and got a whole bunch more plants. This whole flat of things, all of the things, was $12. So I'm going to be planting these and doing some weeding while he's working on that with you guys. And hopefully it should be a manageable project for the afternoon. I think it's like 2 o'clock already. So
the first thing I have to do isn't really part of the watering system itself, but I never added an overflow to our IBC tote. You know, we're not there yet, but eventually this thing will probably fill up. So I'm going to just use one of these bulkhead fittings. I'm going to drill a hole in the side right towards the top. We'll put this in and then we'll just have a drain pipe that comes down and drains onto the ground. I'm going to drill this from the outside with my little hole saw, but then I'm going to have to like reach in here and stick this through and then thread this on. I can reach, I checked before I started drilling. That way we don't have to worry about this thing backing up through the gutter at all. And then I can start on the actual water piping for the chickens. And I left my drill inside. All right, now the fun part. This just has a little gasket on it, so it'll seal on the backside if the water ever gets up that high. Also though, I'll show the hose spout that we're gonna attach to this, and we're gonna be able, it'll have an extra outlet on it, so we'll be able to use it on a hose if we wanna water anything that's below this, which is the whole cottage garden, or we'll be able to use it to fill up a watering can. So if we notice this thing getting really high, we'll probably use the water for other stuff. But the overflow is just, we don't back up our gutters, really. All right, well, this wouldn't be a plumbing project if I didn't buy the wrong fitting at least once. So I thought this was a slip fitting on this side, but it's not, it's threaded. So I will have to get a like threaded end so I can thread a tube into here, or if they have pre-threaded sections of tube, I'll just pick one of those up. Either way, this is just gonna thread in here. I don't need this right now. I can do this at the end of the day when I'm done. This will just thread in here, and then we'll have an outlet tube like this, so it can drain off any extra water. We got the overflow installed, the pipe. I'll have to get a different pipe connection, but that's fine. So now we can start on the actual outlet section here that is going to water the birds. I'll try and explain this as best I can. So we are going to have, obviously, a connection right here at the tank. And then I think I'm going to have a little section of hard tubing that goes along the bottom of the tote there. And then we have a soft, flexible section of hose that will bridge the gap between the tote and the actual coop. Then at the coop, we'll have one section of pipe running lengthwise that way that the chicken will have the chicken watering nipples in it. And then it will branch off and come down and have a section that goes that way into the duck run. And then we have some of the cups that will fill up when the ducks push them down. Nice, it's a good start. So we got the right adapter. And this is our little double outlet here. So we'll connect the watering system probably to that one, just because it's a little harder to get to. And then we'll be able to use this forward one for extra hose or filling up a watering can or anything we want to. This is brass going into plastic, so it probably doesn't even need thread tape, but put a little on there just to hopefully stop any leaks before they start. If this doesn't seal, I'll probably take it back off and, I don't know, use some silicone or something at this joint here and let it dry and then put it back on. The thought of building all this with like a few different threaded connections and like a flexible section is that we will be able to take it apart and clean it. I will be using pipe cement on some of the joints, but like at the end of the watering runs, I'm just going to silicone the caps on. That way, if we need, probably once a year or so, we can take the caps off, flush it all out, and make sure it stays clean. So far it doesn't leak. I just opened the water valve to test it.
So my idea was I was going to have this hard section here connected with a soft hose. The main purpose for this is just to kind of keep everything off the ground and to give like a solid connection where I'm bridging this gap between the tote and the coop. Kind of drops down here, so the hose is going to just be hanging there a little bit. I think I'm just going to zip tie this here so we can take it off if needed. This is a scrap that I had cut. I'm going to just leave this the length it is. I kind of like how it sits, where it sits out here. It's not sticking out too far. I'm going to glue the barb fittings on either end of it and zip tie it here and then start fitting what we've got over there.
Use these bricks as my handy dandy workbench. Hopefully there's no poison ivy around. Since we can't actually connect it at the tote yet, that's really all I need to do right there. For now, I am going to start mocking up and taking some measurements for what we need to cut right here. Because like I said, remember, we're going to have, it's going to come like in straight here, and then it's going to branch off that way and branch off that way and then also go down. So I kind of want to assemble that branch piece with the height change and all the fittings.
We will actually have to come through the chicken wire or the hardware cloth, which is fine. So, will my tape fit? It does. All right. So we're gonna need about a 7-inch piece because I want all of this stuff to mount on the back side of this so it's easy for me to fasten it with like conduit clamps, just screw it right into here. So I'm gonna have a 7-inch piece that comes straight out here and we'll have our hose barb on it to connect the soft section back to the tote. So 7 inches, that'll come out of this T. Left hand side of the T will just run straight to the chicken waterers. A 90 degree fitting down, a length of pipe, and then another 90 degree fitting over to give the ducks theirs. We need to kind of, I need to go in there and take some, maybe measure a chicken or two and see how high up, because the nipples point straight down. So they need to be low enough where the chickens obviously can get to them, but not so low where they need to like crouch. Find some relatively poop-free spots to set things. So we marked out how tall Ego was, and we marked out how tall one of the smaller chickens was. Peach, I think it was. Ego was 14 inches up. And Peach was 13 and a half. Should I do?
Just do 14.
14?
Yeah, okay. I'd rather have them have to like hop up than Ego not be able to access it well.
Yeah, okay. 14.
I think we need to try and measure a duck now.
Well, here they come.
Hello, Ruse. So the ducks can bend over.
Yeah.
So we want their
water. Well, because there's our cups, right?
Right, there's our cups anyway. So, do you think if we just put their cups, like, with the level of this?
The 2x4?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think mounting it on that would be perfect, actually.
Okay, because what I'm going to do, I'll come straight down.
Well, because then they won't kick a bunch of leaves and stuff in it.
Yeah, hopefully. Well, I mean, I think it'll probably still get, like, some tree debris and stuff.
It's going to get mud in it.
Yeah, from their little bills, but we'll have to spray them out every now and then.
Yeah.
Probably every couple days. So, we have our completed, joint system here. I think I'm ready to go mount this back in the coop. And I'll probably put another conduit clamp on it somewhere just to hold it from tipping around like this. Then we can measure exactly how long we need the chicken run to be, how long we need the duck run to be, get those cut, and then I'll probably go install the actual watering nipples and watering cups like up on the porch or something. I forgot to turn the camera on, but I measured and cut the two runs of pipe that will actually hold the waterers. We have 102 inches for the chicken waterer. It's going to run between our two 6x6 posts that are part of the main coop structure, and it's going to overhang on one end with the cap, so it's easy to take the cap off and rinse it out when we need to. The duck one is 64 inches. It's going to run from that 6x6 where we mounted all the joints over to the next 4x4 post of the run. And again, it will overhang so we can take the cap off easily when we need to. The caps I'm talking about, they're just PVC caps. Like I said, I am going to silicone caulk these on. There shouldn't be much water pressure on these, so the silicone caulk should hold fine. That will allow us to grab these and pop them off whenever we need to clean out the pipes. So I am going to...
A little clucker. It's a 5-pack. I can only find one.
Okay. That's
probably enough.
Okay. So I am going to mark out where I need to drill holes on the chicken watering section. I think I'm going to just put one every foot for the first 8 feet. The reason I have to keep them all in line here too is the watering nipples, they need the water pressure on the back of them to keep them sealed, and then when the chickens peck them and push them up, they get drips of water on the metal part. I don't have them perfectly vertical in our A-frame watering setup that is basically a smaller version of this, and they do drip and leak a little bit. I'm going to have to redo that one. It's got some leaks in other spots too, but I'm doing my best to keep them so when I, well, doing my best to mount them so they will all stay vertical, or at least close to vertical, and that way the water pressure that is in the pipe will keep them closed and they won't. And I'm just going to follow the instructions. The watering nipples say to do a 3/8 hole. And then you really just thread them into the PVC. I have a 23/64, which is just under 3/8. I'm gonna use that just to get a tighter fit. Cause like when you thread these into the PVC, if they're a little loose or don't seat right, they'll leak like I found on the other one. If it's a little too tight with this size drill bit, I'll go to 3/8. But usually when you're drilling into something like this too, the drill bit will make the hole a little bigger. So these have a little gasket on them, and you can put Teflon tape. If I don't have to, I'd rather not. These are kind of finicky, and that's kind of just another leak point. So I'll drill the hole, and hopefully the gasket that's on them will do its job. I'm gonna go find the socket that is the right size for this, so I can just use like a little quarter inch ratchet to thread them all in. It'll be much easier than using a wrench.
It did what I thought it was gonna do, and this is probably not tight enough to actually seal on the thread. There is a gasket in here, but the gasket doesn't sit flat either because it's on a round pipe. So unfortunately, I'm gonna have to put some pipe tape on these. Not a big deal, it should seal just fine. It's just kind of an extra step. I'll be amazed if out of all 8 of these, none of them. If these leak, I might take them off and try and put O-rings on them. I think I'd get a better seal with kind of a thick O-ring. These seals are kind of like square cut, and they're clear, so you won't see it, but when you tighten them down, since they're like a flat profile, they kind of get caught and then like want to twist out of place. So if a lot of them leak, I'll probably try and put O-rings on these. I could put silicone on all of them, but it's kind of messy and I'd rather not. Oh yeah, this one's good.
So these are the duck cups. They'll thread into the side of the pipe, and then they only let water out. They're spring-loaded with a little spring. They'll only let water out when they're pushed down. So the ducks can dip their little bills in here and get some water. And we will have to clean these out every now and then, but they have a little gasket too. It's in a much thicker, larger gasket, so I'm quite a bit more confident in this one. I should give a shout out. I don't know who it was, but somebody sent us all of these watering cups. We bought the chicken nipples at Tractor Supply, but somebody sent these to us, I think, off our Amazon wish list. So thank you very much. That was very helpful. And we're finally getting to use them. So if you sent them, hopefully you see this. Yeah, that thread's in much nicer with just a slightly undersized hole. So here's the pipe with all the duck cups in it. I'm just reusing this bottle. I filled it with water. I'm gonna pour it in this pipe. The end cap isn't glued on, so it may just leak out of the end cap, but I'm gonna just try and leak check this before I install it. They don't appear to be leaking out of the gasket. So we're going to call that a win. We'll try the same thing with the chicken pipe. I expect it's going to leak. I think we're going to install this and just keep an eye on it. If we have to fix it later, so be it. A little messy. It's been a couple days, but I am back working on this. I got the couple fittings I need to correct the overflow where I got the wrong fitting. And I got an adapter for a hose to go on here, so we can connect this soft hose to our sections of pipe. Last two connections we had to make in this system, there's water hooked up to it now. I'm gonna open the valve and just check for leaks one last time. I'm gonna look at the silicone sealed joints that we did in there, make sure those don't have any leaks, and I'll probably try and get some water down into those waterers for the birds. So you can see, we actually have some drips coming out of a couple of these. And when I went in there and tightened them up, they actually start leaking worse because the gasket that's on there is not really good for how these seal. I'm gonna pull these out and try and replace the gasket with O-rings and see if that stops the leaking. I didn't feel like stopping. There is one of these O-ring sizes from this kit that fits really well. So hopefully these do a little better job.
Pull the lever, Kronk.
So we have water.
It works. Is it leaking?
I don't see a bunch of water leaking out of the chicken ones.
Drink your waters. You look thirsty, Eggo.
Eggo gets it. Good boy.
He's almost too gentle.
I know.
Like, he doesn't move the nipple.
There you go. Good job. Go, Peach, go! Can you, like, hold your hand under one of the cups? They kind of accidentally drink out of it then. There we go! Good job, Bill! He put his head below it.
Oh.
Edith got them all figured out. She just used every single one of them. Good job, guys. Is there anything else you would like to say?
I'm happy it's done. We still need to pour some vinegar in the tote and put the cover back on. I hope you enjoyed it more than I did.